I think that we really just wanted to make a genuinely sort of crunchy, real tasting, real sounding, real moving, real grooving record. Not something which was over machined. Having played as an entity in clubs and pubs and bars and stadia around the planet and still being together after this period of time, you want to do something which is whole. And it's a whole record, and I think that's why we feel very positive about it.
It's been a very industrial album. You've got people who make furniture over here, and you've got people who mix chemicals over here. And you feel like you're in a working environment, and that's, you know, it's record making in the 90s. Real record making, real records.
There's been no high-tech technology in there at all, no computers. Everything's played. If it's a shaker, it's someone standing there, you know, rather than putting it on Cubase, having this thing precisely dictating everything. So everything speeds up or slows down. It's human, which is, it's good to listen to, and it's good to play.
I mean, some people run 10 miles from their past and they just don't want to know about it, but it was, whenever you do a live album, you're always confronted with your past. You know, all the tapes that you get are from, each tape has a particular memory of a particular show that you did. And the way we put the live album together, we pull tapes from the last more or less 10 years together. And in listening to that, I think we felt that we might have, you know, we should go back and explore, you know, what the basic sound of the band is, without too much ornamentation. I mean, and just get the heart of it recorded. I think it's good to be confronted with your past. I think it's, in this case, it sort of worked, you know. I think, and it's rubbed off a bit on the on this album, because sometimes you can lose the very essence of what you are by being a bit clever.
When we sat down and listened to all those shows together, you know, when the door was closed and we were really honest with each other, it was a good chance to analyse what we were doing, and then to come and do an album after that, I think gave us a sort of encouragement to do that, to just get in a room and play and record it how it sounds. I wish I could see this great mystery,
earth and sun and moon, human tribe. Hopefully the songs are strong. In fact, it's been an oil thing, you know, for a while now. Don't even go into a recording studio until you've got your songs together. You've got good, strong songs, you can play them a variety of ways. If you haven't got strong songs, you tend to make up for it with technology and bring out all the gear. Of course, we didn't want to do that.
I think the songs are more personal because you just get to a stage where you want to be honest. And, I mean, I think we've been honest in the past, but we've just had really strong, if you like, ideological things that we've wanted to get off our chests. And there's always been this sense that, you know, Midnight Oil is this incredible dialogue that goes on, you know, sort of these incredible statements about the world, but what is it about the people? And, you know, there's a few bits and pieces of the people that slipped out onto this one.
It's going to be a much more accessible album for the audience and for us to play on stage. It should be damn good.
You're trying to write a record and make a record which has got real meaning, you know, that just isn't a set of cliches, you know, hooked up to a chorus. And you're also trying to do it with a bunch of other people that you've known for some time, and quite often you're sharing songs with them. And I reckon that, for me anyway, the groovy thing about singing in a band, for it still to be exciting, it's got to groove along and it's got to be very real. It's got to be quite chunky and have lots of grunt. And that's what we tried to do, and that's why we came to a place like this, you know, so. But it didn't sound like it had fairy dust sprinkled all over it.
In my shoes,
You know, it's got... We've now got Larger Than Life with a line on it. We've also got The Scream with a line on it. In other words, we've got everything on it.
Basically, more is more. And if it isn't clear enough, put more on it.
Yeah, the more is more.
So what are you saying? Piss it off.
Liberation Front is winning tonight.
Piss it off or...
No. No. Keep it in.
I think as long as it's quiet.
It's just a lot. It doesn't matter if you hear the last one.
And the last
one. It's like an anguished scream from Koala Hill. Mate, you're close. You're very close.
Yeah. The first time I did with them was 1098, and that was 10 years ago. In fact, it was 10 years almost to the day when we started this one, which was a really bizarre coincidence. I think they're very unique in the way that they all play together, which is so important for a band. I think the way that Martin and Jim play their guitars, the way they play off each other, is very, very special. And it's pretty, I mean, there are probably quite a lot of guitar bands that have two guitarists where they play off, but this is something different. I mean, whenever they play acoustic guitars together, whenever we do put acoustics on tracks, we tend to sort of run both of them playing at the same time with different types of guitars. One might play a dobro and the other one will play a sort of smaller six-string acoustic. And one of them always plays a little bit behind the beat and one plays ahead, and they stay at exactly that distance from the central beat all the way through the song. So it just makes this big sound. They ain't good, they're great.
We feel pretty comfortable out here, you know. It's hot, it's dry, it's Australian, it smells right.
It's hostile.
There's a big bull ant flying up my leg as we speak. This seems like a good place to start a Midnight Oil film clip. Whenever Midnight Oil makes a film clip, it's about 105 degrees. We went to Kalgoorlie in Western Australia for the last one. And I think it's going to be about 106 today. So it's just part of what we do, isn't it?
Remember Zulu? Zulu 2. Remember Ben-Hur? Ben-Hur 3. Remember the great crowd scene on the steps of the Russian Parliament with Potemkin? Potemkin 5. Australia's theatre and acting and movie industry, the cream of the crop, is all here.
And action!
Truganini is really... It's about Truganini, the last remaining Tasmanian Aboriginal person. It's about Namajira, the international watercolourist, but it's actually about what Australia's doing with itself in the last decade of this century.
What does the clip actually involve? People, you guys pulling trucks up hills?
You got to start somewhere. Got a better idea?
What do you want, pretty girls? Don't get you nowhere. Yeah.
This is where we run through naked.
This is it. Get your gear off, boy. Sorry, didn't I mention this before?
It's, concept number six, yeah.
Pretty standard.
Guys, spread out so you're not like a small minority group.
Right.
Just kind of spread yourselves among. Yeah. Yeah. Rob, can we have you in the shot too, please? And Peter, can we get you in shot, sir? I'm sorry, Nicky. No, the oils are dressed in this shot. Next clip.
lines are down. We'll be staying at the Roma bar till that monsoon passes on. That show. Go round.